to build a hope and a world of fears. There's so much that we share that it's done. We're aware it's a small world after all.
Welcome to my channel. If you are new, hi, I'm Roxanna. In today's video, I'm going to be talking about the do's and don'ts of Disney. If for those of you who don't know, I am a former Disney cast member. I did the Disney College program back in fall 2010. I did the regular fall program. I did not do the Fall Advantage program. And after working for Disney for like 6 months and gone on countless Disney vacations, I've had my fair share of mistakes. So I'm sharing my mistakes with you so that you guys don't make them. Also, I now have a Facebook group. It is Life of Roxanna. I'm going to post it right here for you guys and go follow me there. And I also have a Snapchat. It is Life W Roxanna. I will post my Snapchat here, and I also post the links down below. And I also have an Instagram, which is Life with Roxanna, and that's also linked down below. I have a P.O. box. A lot of people don't know. I will post that down below. It's raining. I come back from sunny Hawaii, hot and humid weather, and I come back to rain. Yep. Life in Illinois doesn't get any interesting than that. Also, I hit 146, as of recording this, subscribers while I was in Hawaii. I had planned on doing a 100 subscriber giveaway. That's now going to be turning into a 200 subscriber giveaway. So when I hit 200 subscribers, be on a lookout for a 200 subscriber giveaway video. Anyways, enough blabbing. Let's get on to the do's and don'ts. Okay, so my first do is going to be a necessity. It's going to be something that you must bring. Do bring a refillable water bottle, like the kinds that you can get from like the Disney store or Target. Let me show you what I'm talking about. A water bottle like this that is refillable, that you could just go up to any of the kiosks, ask for a glass of ice water, pour it in, you're good to go, you're staying hydrated. Staying hydrated, especially in the Florida heat and humidity, is a must. Speaking of rain, do bring a poncho. It does rain in Florida just about every single day in the afternoon. You don't want to get caught in the rain without a poncho or an umbrella. So a poncho and an umbrella, or an umbrella, or both a poncho and an umbrella, are a must. Now, don't leave your good walking shoes at home. Bring good walking shoes because you're going to do a lot of walking. You're going to do over a mile worth of walking. You're going to do at least 10,000 steps. Trust me on that, 10,000 or more. I've got it calculated on my phone. My phone tracks my steps for me, so I've checked, and yes, you will be taking that many steps or more. And another thing is do bring sunscreen. You're in Florida. It's hot. it does get sunny, the last thing you want to do that wants to happen is getting sunburned, looking like a lobster on vacation. Like, that's no fun. So do bring your sunscreen. What is optional is bug spray. I know Disney does a very good job with spraying their parks and resorts so that the bugs don't get into the mosquitoes don't get into the parks and resorts. The only resort where, if you were to stay on Disney property, where you would absolutely 100% need bug spray for is the wilderness, the campgrounds. Only because they're trying to give you the full camping experience at the full wilderness resort at their campgrounds. So you're gonna get attacked by bugs, and Florida bugs are like huge, ridiculously huge, trust me. Especially love bugs. If you don't know what a love bug is, count your blessings. Basically, it's two bugs that are connected to each other, and well, I don't need to explain. So that, if you are staying at the campsite or the cabins, you for sure going to need bug spray. If you're staying at the other resorts, Disney does a good job spraying them so that you don't get attacked by mosquitoes. Don't shove. The next don't is don't shove. If you have a stroller, your own stroller or one of the rental strollers from Disney, don't shove your way. It's no fun, trust me. I've been to the parks where people would just run other people over with strollers. Or what also goes along with this is if you have your own wheelchair, or if you have your own scooter, or hold on 1 second. Sorry about that. My phone decided to randomly ring. If you have your own wheelchair, or if you have your own scooter, or if you're renting a wheelchair or scooter. My dogs have an opinion on this as well. Doggies, that's enough. Bailey, come here. Don't run people over with it, or don't block the sidewalks or the walkways with them. It's have common courtesy. The parks are going to be packed regardless what time of the year you go. Just make an open pathway, let other people pass. If you're stopping to kind of decide what restaurant to go to or what ride to go to, or you're kind of looking at the map to see directions to get to where you need to get you to the other area of a park, just go off to the side, find a cast member, make walking easy in the park, don't go blocking. And another don't line jump, don't cut people in line. There's a reason why the wait times are the wait times. Wait times only get longer, and the lines only get longer when people line jump or cut, which is very, very, very annoying. I've seen it happen so many times. It's happened to me. I've seen it happen to other people. It's flat out rude. Don't do it. Like, you're not gonna get to the front of the line faster by doing that. You're only making everyone that's been waiting in line before you, that has been waiting in line much longer than you, mad. You don't want to cause a scene, and you'll get dirty looks. Trust me, you'll get dirty looks. Don't be that family that will save spots for a parade or the fireworks 3 hours before. Doggies, that's enough. They also have an opinion on that, apparently. Before the parade or fireworks starts, and block off an entire section and not have good, not let everyone else have a chance to get a spot. Do you need to get to the fireworks and parade early to save a spot? Yes, but not 2 to 3 hours worth. It's no. Just don't be, let other people kind of like, if you only have a small party, don't go taking up a huge section of like the parade route and not let others kind of like see the parade. It's rude. It's happened to me and a friend before. It did not turn out right. A friend of mine had, I'll briefly explain the story. Basically, I was at Mickey's Not So Scary Halloween party. Myself and my friend had, excuse me, had just got done seeing the villain show. It was the mix and mingle, the villains mix and mingle show. And I was in line to meet some of the villains, and my friend who was saving on spots was like, hey, look, I have a friend that is meeting the villains right now. Is it okay if I save a spot for her? They're like, yeah, sure, it's fine. It turned out to be two different families that obviously weren't related to each other. They were like, yeah, that's fine. I came, they completely blocked off the sidewalk to where my friend was, and it was one American family, one UK family. I could tell the UK family based off of their accent. Just being rude, blocking my way to get to my friend. And they said, oh, we purposely did that. Even though they were told ahead of time that my friend had gotten there early, that I was coming after meeting the villains, and yeah, they decided to be rude. So don't do that. Another don't. And a lot of rookies make this mistake. Dogs. Alright, sorry. I keep getting interrupted. My dad had to ask me a question about a shoe that he had ordered. Anyways, so what was I saying? Yeah, don't be rude with blocking the parade or firework route at all. Speaking of rude, my dogs like to pop in and out as they please. Anyways, and don't. This is a don't, and this is a legit question. It's not just a question that they tell cast members during traditions. Traditions is basically what they call orientation, except for it's a lot more fun than basic orientation. Don't go asking a cast member what time the 3 o'clock parade, because the response you get may not be the response you're looking for. We'll respond with, we'll kind of just look at you like, you mean, where's a good spot for the 3 o'clock parade? Because, and Disney does have a shirt with Goofy on it asking what time the 3 o'clock parade is at. Another don't, and this has happened to me. Don't go asking cast members where they live. It's rude. It's an invasion of privacy. We're not gonna give out any of that information. It's just courtesy, people. Common courtesy. Oh my word. Do, however, bring your own snacks. You can bring your own snacks into the parks, into your park bag. Especially if you're someone that has food allergies, you can bring your own snacks. I bring my own snacks to snack on while I'm waiting in line for a ride. It's something to kind of keep my energy level up. I also, as a kind of going along with, do pack those like sports drink packets, the kind that the like that you can squeeze in onto your water bottle. excuse me. So basically, when I'm telling Charlie, you stay hydrated. Those are all my do's and don'ts for Disney. If you have any, if I missed any, comment them down below, your do's and don'ts. I'm very interested. I know I missed a lot. I keep getting interrupted, otherwise I would keep going on and I'm losing my train of thought. So if you are new, I would love it if you would hit the subscribe button, click on the notification bell, and join the Disney Nerd family. Alright, I'll see you lovely Disney Nerds in my next video. Bye. It's a world of laughter, a world of tears. It's a world of hope and a world of fears. Just so much that